space and we tested all these things, and considering all the mobile phones that are out there and the different versions of the operating systems alone, using something like our mobile services environment, you can test out mobile applications.
The sound of a fight. Father has spoken.
As an AWS Certified Solutions Architect Associate, and I wanted to share my approach with those who might be interested. Literally, I do have a solid technical background, but I believe the following were the key activities that helped me learn AWS. First, watching A-Cloud Guru videos.
Hi there, my name's Ryan Kronenberg. I'm one of the co-founders of A-Cloud Guru. So I teach 5 courses on our platform, the 3 AWS Associate courses and the Professional course. And I also teach an Alexa course, which is about making skills for Amazon Echo. We literally assume you know nothing and start you right from the very beginning. Back in about 2010, I went to do my job interview with Amazon. And they didn't hire me, and it actually turned out to be the best thing that ever happened to me, because I thought to myself, if I don't get this job, I'll do my own AWS courses, because I think I could do a really good job of it. I'm also a big fan of gadgets. You know, we've got a robot dog at home, which my son absolutely loves. We've also got a self-playing piano, so it's amazing. It's like my favorite thing in the whole wide world.
Of course, there are pros and cons. Let's talk about pros. First of all, it's cheap, only $30, with unlimited access to its online content. And the online course is flexible. You should be able to watch and learn by your own pace. And it's active discussion forum. You can easily have your questions answered in a timely manner. I spent lots of time answering questions and reading about people's experiences on the A-Cloud Guru forum. Of course, there are cons. Some videos, courses, they might not be up to date, but it doesn't really matter, because AWS announces new technology almost every day. The course maybe covers only 70 to 75% of the exam. So you have to do your homework. You will have to read lots of additional white papers. Do as many as possible lab works. Practice makes perfect. Repetition. This might not suit for those who are already working in an AWS environment. And again, I'm not a technical guy. I don't have too much hands-on experience on AWS in my day-to-day work. There's no shortcut to pass the exam, unless you're a genius. I had my hands on and building things in AWS as much as I could, such as I built VPCs with Bastions, NAS, VPC's endpoint, and local traffic on a subnet. To test my readiness for the exam, I did tons of practice exams. I took notes on wrong questions. By doing it, I could identify the weakness I had. Honestly, I didn't finish reading all recommended documents. I read what I needed. For instance, DynamoDB Ryan said in his video, you don't have to know it. You just know it in a high level. But there are quite a few questions in the practice exam. I did some deep dive into that topic. Repetition, repetition, repetition. I don't have a good memory, but I did watch some of the videos 5 to 6 times to enhance some of the basic concepts. The mindset I've had when learning about AWS has been to try to understand things, not just memorize them. In particular, I wanted to understand how services and features are implemented. I need to know why the configuration has to be set up that way. I'd like to clarify that none of what I described above should be considered necessary. I could have taken a different path to learning AWS and passing my exams, and you probably will. I only meant to share what I found particularly useful. If I could do it, I believe you all can do it. Let's do it. Remember this. The best way to predict your future is to create it.